Hello everyone, I am Maafreen, teacher of Milestone Preparatory KG School. Welcome you all our math online class again. At first, I would like to extend my warmest wishes to you all. How are you all? I hope all of you are doing well. So students, look, what is this in my hand? Yes, this is 1000 taka note. Can you guess what is our today's topic? Yes, very good. Today's again our topic is Bangladeshi coins and notes. So I hope that already you have learned the basic information from this chapter. So can I ask you some question from our previous class? Okay, get ready for the question. So at first, tell me the first question for you. What is the relation between taka and paisa? Okay, very good. Right answer. It is 1 taka is equal to 100 paisa. Now, tell me the next question. Which note has the picture of National Parliament? It is very easy question for you. Yes, very good. 1000 taka note. Look at this note again. I have brought it for you to show you that look at the picture of 1000 taka note. And there is the picture of our National Parliament. So it is our answer that will be 1000 taka note and there is the picture of National Parliament. Now next question. Can you tell me how many coins are there in Bangladesh? Yes, very good. There are 8 types of coins in Bangladesh. So you gave all the question answer correctly. Very good. Students, I know that already you have learned the basic information from this chapter, Bangladeshi coins and notes. And already we have done the addition of taka and paisa and subtraction of taka and paisa. So today, our CW number will be 37. And everybody open your book in front of you. And from page 81, today I will show you two words problem. At first, I will show you problem number 3 from the page 81. So look at the question at first, student. The question is for you. Sujon has 70 taka 50 paisa. His mother gave him 95 taka to buy fish. How much amount did Sujon have? So I told you before that whenever they will give you the word problem, you have to read out the question attentively. And you know in word problem there are some parts, information parts and asking part. And by using the information, we have to think that which method we have to apply here. Okay, so look at the question again, that Sujon had 70 taka 50 paisa and his mother gave him 95 taka to buy fish, and they are asking you how much amount did Sujon have. Now so you think like this way, that if anyone give you something, then what happened? Your number will be increased. Okay, so Sujon mother gave him 95 taka. So which method we have to apply here to find out the solution? Yes, it is the word problem of addition. Because Sujon mother gave him 95 taka and now the amount of taka will be increased. And whenever something is increased, that time we have to apply addition method. Okay, so let's start. I am writing the solution. At first, I have to write, and there is taka and paisa. also. Okay. So I have to maintain this writing. Sujon had 70 taka. We have to separately write taka and paisa. 70 taka, 50 paisa. Okay. Then his mother gave him. His mother gave him how much taka? 95 taka. His mother gave him. So we have to do their addition. And look there. His mother gave him 95 taka, but there is no paisa options. They did not mention here any paisa, but as we have to write it in the solution, so for our calculation, we have to think that there will be 00 paisa with 95 taka. Okay, so I have to write here 95 taka, 00 paisa. Okay, be attentive everybody. Now what should we do? I told you that here we have to do the addition to find out the answer. So from which side we have to do the addition? From the right side. At first we have to do the paisa side. So do the addition here, and we have to write here total. We have to find out here that how much amount did Sujon have, that total taka, how much taka Sujon have. So do the addition. It is very easy, you know. 0 plus 0, what will be there? 0 plus 0, obviously it will be 0. And this will be 0 plus 5. What will be there? Come, it is very easy. 5, okay. 50 paisa will be there. Now, I have to do the addition in this part, that is taka. Look at here. Here is 5 and there is upper part is 0. So, do the addition. 5 plus 0, it will be 5 here. And now, 9 plus 7. Use your finger line. 9 plus 7. What will be there? 9 will be there. And up to 7 finger line, I have to count. So 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. I got here 16. So here I got 165 taka 50 paisa. This is the total amount of taka that Sujon has. So I have to write the answer now. And again, I am telling that if anybody gave you something, then in that case, our number will be increased, our taka will be increased. That time we have to follow the addition method. Okay, so write down the answer. It is very easy for you, I think. At least I have to write Sujon had 165 taka 50 paisa. Okay, so everybody write down it in your CW copy. I hope all of you have understood this easy problem. Now I move on for the next problem for you. Okay, now students, I will show you problem number 5 from page 81. So look at the question attentively. The price of 2 exercise book is taka 60 and that of a pen is 45 taka 60 paisa. Bijoy gives the shopkeeper a note of 500 taka. For these items, how much will the shopkeeper return to Bijoy? So students, they have given you here some information that Bijoy bought 2 exercise books and also he bought a pen. Okay, two items he bought here. And after buying this item, he gave to the shopkeeper 500 taka note. And the question is for you that how much will the shopkeeper return to bidder? That means back to bidder. So to find out this answer, at first, what should we do? My dear students, you know, return is the clue word of subtraction. So how can I find out that how much money the shopkeeper returned to Bijoy? If we don't know that what is the total cost of these two items or how much money Bijoy spent in the shop. At first, we have to find out this thing. Otherwise, we cannot find out this answer that how much will the shopkeeper return to Bijoy. So at first we have to find out the total cost of Bijoy. Otherwise we cannot find out the answer. So here we have to find out the total cost and total he has bought two items, two exercise book and another item is pen. So these two item amount of taka we have to add here to find out the total cost of Bijoy. So let's start solve this problem. And at first I have to write the first part. We have to find out the total cost of Bijoy at first. So we have to write 2 exercise book is what is the amount of 2 exercise book? The 2 exercise book is taka. Look here again, they have given you only taka 6. Okay, I am using this 60 taka. And look, in book items there are no paisa with this taka, but for our calculation we have to write here 0 paisa, because in the pen there is a paisa also with taka. So I am writing here pen is, we have to do the addition here because we have to know the total cost of Bijoy. So these two item, exercise book and pen item cost, we have to do the addition. To find out this, we have to do the addition. 45 taka and there is also 60 paisa. So now we are doing the addition here from the right side. Paisa at first we have to add. So 0 plus 0 what will be there? It will be 0. And 6 plus 0 it will be what? Again it will be the same thing. 6. So 60 paisa I have written here. And now go to the taka part. 5 plus 0 it will be what? 5. And it will with taka, I am writing here, and 4 plus 6, use your finger line, 4 plus 6 will be what? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, it will be 10. So this is 105 taka 60 paisa, and this is the total cost of Bijoy. Total cost. Okay, so this is not our final answer, students. We have to find out at first the total cost of Bijoy, that how much money he spent to buy these two items, exercise books and pen. Now I got the total cost of Bijoy. So how can I find out that how much will the shopkeeper return to Bijoy. We know that Bijoy gave to the shopkeeper 500 taka note. So from this 500 taka note, if I subtract this total cost, then what should we get? Yes, we'll get the returning money. The shopkeeper will return to Bijoy. So in the last part, we have to do the what? We have to do here the subtraction to find out the returning money. Now students, I am writing the second part. Bijoy gives to the shopkeeper 500 taka, we know 500 taka. And look, in the total cost part, there is paisa also with this taka. But here, Bijoy gives to the shopkeeper with this 500 taka, there is no paisa. But for our calculation, we have to write here 00 paisa. Okay? And now I will write total cost. This total cost we find out by doing the addition at first. So this is the our subtraction problem. To find out the returning money, we have to do here the subtraction method. So total cost we got it here 105 taka 60 paisa. Now we are doing the subtraction here. But students, look at there. Here is 00 paisa in the upper part, and in the lower part there is 60 paisa. So can we do the subtraction here? No, we cannot do the subtraction here, because we know the rules of subtraction that if in the upper part there is smaller number, then we cannot do the subtraction. So what should I do now? Yes, my dear students, here we have to increase the amount of paisa. But how can I increase the number of paisa? This is the question, isn't it? Yes, there is a way we can increase the amount of paisa here. How can it possible? Yes, if I borrow 1 taka from the 500 taka, then easily I can increase the number of paisa. So how can I do it? Okay, so you students, there is the relation between taka and paisa, that 1 taka is equal to 100 paisa. So if I borrow from 1 taka, then what happened? What changes will be come here? So look at this rapport. I am showing here that if I borrow 1 taka, then in taka part there will be 1 taka will be less. So 500 taka minus 1 taka, then it will be what? 500 minus 1 taka, it will be 499 taka. And as I have borrowed from the taka part, then what happened? My number of paisa will be increased. So at first I have 00 paisa, now it will be plus 100. So it will be 100 paisa. So totally our this part will be changed. So this thing we have to show as a rapport, that what changes will come here. And you have to show the rapport also, that if I borrow 1 taka from this 500 taka, then what changes will come here? So I have to do here 500 minus 1, it will be 499 taka now, and 0 paisa will become now 100 paisa. And now we cannot do it here in this part, because if I am to do it here, then what happened? Then it becomes clumsy. So if you show it in the rougher, then it will be better for us. Now students, we have to do the subtraction, and we can do the subtraction in the rougher as some changes has come in the first part. So I am showing this subtraction in the rougher. So my first part, look, there will be 499 taka 100 paisa, and the second part I have written 105 taka 60 paisa. Now do the subtraction here, and at the right side we are starting. So look, 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0 will be what? Obviously 0. So I have written 0. Go to the next part. 0 is the upper number and 6 is the lower number. So can I do the subtraction here? No, we cannot do the subtraction here. So what should I do? So tens place will borrow 100 from the 100 place, and 10 place will get here 10. As we know that 100 means 10. So now do the subtraction. 10 plus 0, it will be 10. At 10 minus 6, it will be what? Do the subtraction. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It will be 4. So I have written here 4. And go to the next number. And next number, there is no number because 100 has given 100 to the tens place. Okay, so there will be nothing. So I got here 40 paisa. So now go to the taka part. Look at there will be 9 minus 5. So easily you can do the subtraction. 9 minus 5. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It will be 4. And go to the next number now. 9 minus 0. So it will be obviously 9. And go to the next part now. 4 minus 1. So 4 minus 1 will be what? It will be 3. Yes, very good. So I got the answer here 395 taka 40 paisa. Students, I have shown here the rougher so that in this main part it should not be clumsy, so that you can also do the rougher. And after completing this rougher, I can write the final answer here. That is 394 taka 40 paisa. And here I have to write shopkeeper will return. Shopkeeper will return to Bijoy 394 taka 40 paisa. This is our final answer. And in this main part, you can give a sign of that we have borrowed 1 taka from this taka place, and 1 taka means 100 paisa. You can give the rough side note here. Okay. So now at last, write down the answer. Shopkeeper will return 394 taka 40 paisa to Bijoy. Okay. So everybody write down this. Everybody write down the answer. And again I am telling that what happened in this problem. Students, in that problem they are asking you that how much money will the shopkeeper return to Bijoy. For that problem, at first we have to know that what is the total cost of the things, And as Vijay bought two items, that is two exercise book and pen, so how much money he spent, how much money was his total cost, at first we have to know. And that's why we have to add these two items, that is two exercise book price and pen price, that is total cost. By doing the addition, we can easily find out this answer. And after getting this answer, we have to do the subtraction here to find out the returning money. And from which line we have to do the subtraction here? From Bijoy gives to the shopkeeper, from this line 500 taka. From this 500 taka, what was his total cost? This amount we have to do the subtraction here. And I am telling you here that as there is 00 portion in the upper part, so we cannot do the subtraction directly here. Okay, so this portion amount we have to increase. So how can we increase? We can increase by borrowing 1 taka from the taka 500. Okay, so lots of changes has come. I have shown you here in the rough of that which change. Just has come in this first part, and as I am doing the rough work here, so I can arrange this number again in the rough work, and I can get the answer from the rough work. And at last I have written this rough work in this main part. And don't forget to give this side note here, that 1 taka equal to 100 paisa, because we have to borrow here 1 taka, and 1 taka and 100 paisa is the same in it, is equal. And at last I have written the answer here. Okay my dear, I hope all of you have understood now, and write down this properly in your CW copy now. So now it's time for taking feedback from you. Get ready for the question my dear, and I hope that all of you can give me the correct answer. Okay, the first question for you. Look at the question. 10 notes of 50 taka equal to, there is a fill in the blanks, taka. So 10 notes of 50 taka, that means what? Think properly, that 50 taka 10 notes. How can I find out this answer? It is very easy. Yes, our answer will be 500 taka. And how can I find this answer? Easily we can find out this answer by doing the multiplication. That 50 taka 10 notes will be 500 taka. Okay, very good. Now, next question for you. Which note has the picture of deer? My dear students, one thing I want to tell you, that you have to observe the notes and coins of Bangladeshi, so that anytime in your short question answer, this type of question can come. That which note has the picture of deer, which coin has the picture of Jamuna Bridge. So we have to observe the coins and notes carefully. Okay, so what will be the answer here? Yes, the answer will be 1 taka note. And I hope that all of you have seen the 1 taka note, and there is a picture of deers. Okay, so students, now is your time for diary writing. Write down the diary and write down, do from page 81, problem number 6 and 7. So I hope that all of you have finished your diary writing. So students, you know that success has no shortcut. So if you practice more and every day you study, then you will be successful in your life. So I wish you a bright, successful life. So that's why we have to keep on practicing all the time. So see you next class. No more today. Bye bye. Take care.